community, and I continually challenge every time someone says something that I think only represents a small part of the community. So what I do, I see it as my job to do that, okay? And I do it a lot, okay? But we are doing some things. So there's a thing called community cultivation grants. So the DA can give money to projects that are happening in different places to help grow the community in those places. Use them. They're actually underused. We quite often don't manage to spend our budget. Probably shouldn't have said that. Okay? But if you know of a place where there are a group of people that need money to get an event started in a different part of India, maybe up in Kashmir, why not? Yeah, okay, let's do it, let's make it happen. Apply for it. It's actually not DA people who decide, the board is actually external to the DA, but let's make it happen. It really matters that we do that. Use the money. Yeah. I've been building Drupal.org/community to try and help people find different parts of our community and so on. These pages will be translatable, okay? And I will be wanting help to translate them, because I think if there's any part of our Drupal.org website that should be in multiple languages, it should be community. All right? Okay. Here's something you weren't seeing yet. So we're also looking at how people interact with each other and knowing what a little bit about the person that you're discussing. Now in the issue queues, anybody who's actually worked on Drupal.org issues before? Anyone? Oh yeah, a few. So one of the things that you'll find, and you'll see this on GitHub and all that type of stuff as well, it's difficult to read the text and understand the context of the person who's doing it. And then if your language is not primarily English, you may write something and someone else will think, well, that's offensive, blah, 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 blah. And you don't know. You're like, what? I don't know. Okay, well, what we're doing is you'll be able to go to your profile on Drupal.org and you'll be able to say, my primary language, the one I speak normally every day, is German. This is Daniel Werner. All right? He likes to be called him. And he lives in London, UK. Yeah? So that will appear on every comment that he makes in the issue queues. And it means that the next person's comment knows that whatever, if you believe it, there's not much written there, whatever he's written, there's some context. Oh, his primary language isn't English. Maybe he's written something and written it in a way that kind of could be interpreted incorrectly or whatever. Yeah? So it slows people down, makes them think, am I going to explode at this or not? Not that they should anyway, but you know. Okay. We can do better. We do sometimes get it wrong. And as I said before, I got it wrong by filming a bunch of guys. Yeah? And not mixing it up a little bit. There's no excuses. I should have known better. Especially me. So it happens, yeah. But we can work better. We can work to make sure that all the different parts of the world, of our community, are represented. I do need help. I'm not going to pretend otherwise. I need help. I can't do it all on my own, yeah. So, as I said before, being able to give time to staff to be involved in things, not just code contribution, but all those other things as well. So give staff time, especially your marketing staff, to help with things like the pitch deck, your senior staff to help with mentoring. Those types of things make a difference because they put your staff, your people, you, into positions of influence. Okay? If there's one thing that we're missing at the moment, possibly, is enough people outside, frankly, America, in positions of influence. So, what are they? They're things like the community working group. They're looking for volunteers right now. Yeah? They're looking for people who can sit there and help in the community working group. It's a position of influence. It's a position that I was in that got me this job. I had to leave because I can't do both jobs at the same time. Yeah? All right? But it means I have a voice by doing that volunteering. And if I have a voice, then the UK has a voice. So, if you're in positions of influence by volunteering, you can help make sure that India has a greater voice. All right? There's been a thing happened recently where someone mentioned that there weren't that many sessions in DrupalCon Seattle selected for speaking this time from India.
Well, hopefully.
All right, cool. Yeah, no. Okay, well, I'll tell you what. I did a bit of investigation. I've not discussed this with anyone yet, but the sessions are not selected by the DA. All right, they're selected by volunteers that make what's called the speaker selection panel. All but one of the volunteers in the speaker selection panel come from North America. Okay? So, and it's no fault of theirs, because we all do this. When you look at a set of speakers, potential speakers, we tend to go for the people that we know. It's a built-in human reaction. We need to make sure that those volunteers on that speaker selection panel next year and the year after are not all from one place, they're from right around the world. Agreed?
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
I will help make that happen if you can give me the people to do it.
Wonderful.
Yeah? Perfect. All right. God, I might have made a promise I can't keep there. There's another thing that goes on. There is an award every year called the Aaron Wimborne Award for great community people. Has anyone here heard of the Aaron Wimborne Award?
Yes.
Yeah? It's a really incredible thing. So Aaron Wimborne was a developer in the Drupal community. He died of ALS, which is the same thing that Stephen Hawking had. Okay? And an award was created for people who do work in the right way in the community. How many people here nominated people from India for that award? Because I know full well that there's plenty of you that should be getting it. That's the type of thing, yeah? That's the type of thing I need, and I can't force you to do it, but I need you to be doing so the people who select the winner are saying, wow, actually, do you know what? There's a lot of Indians here. We need to work out what's going on. Yeah? Oh, this person's cool. All right? That's how we get people here into positions of influence, and that's how we change the focus to recognize the massive contribution that you make. Okay? Well, I'm going to stop there. Any questions? We've got a microphone somewhere. Someone get out with that microphone. So.
So, I think the part of that language bit on Drupal.org is great. So, you know, and you're right, right? What happens a lot of time,
A lot of time, you know, you tend to go with the people that you already heard, you've seen them speaking in the events. And second way of choosing, you know, a person speaker is always the way that they have written their description of what they're speaking in, right? And the past speaking engagement. Now, any non-English speaker, right, or who doesn't have that language, first language, would never be able to compete with a English-speaking person, right, in terms of the description that they would probably, you know, write in, right? So I think that's something that, you know, whoever that speaking selection committee is has to consider that, you know, it would not be always be the that good enough, right?
Oh, so what you're saying is we could have this on our speaker selection?
Yes, yes.
Ah, I like that. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other questions generally about the Drupal Association for me? Can we get the microphone down here? Oh, thank you.
You have shown statistics that India is number 2 in terms of contribution.
In terms of code.
Yeah. But statistics can be sometimes deceptive. What happens is that more rational way of doing it would be to see the number of ports divided by the population in millions and find where India is. The balloon will completely deflate.
I like to think that it depends what... there are a lot of people here, I have noticed this, you're right. There's a lot of people in India. However, remember, more Indian Drupal developers. What do we count as the population? So the population of Drupal developers in the UK could be the same as the population of Drupal developers in the whole of India. I don't know, actually. We can find that out, and I will do. I'll find that out. Yeah? Okay? I think you shouldn't not talk down the contribution you are making, because it is significant, and thank you. Yeah? But I understand what you're saying. These are a lot of people. Is there anybody else? Go on, Manjit, and then we need some ladies.
Based on the same statistics, so India is the second position, right, in Drupal contribution. So do we have any plan for DrupalCon in India?
Okay, actually that is a good question. So what Manjit is asking is, are there any plans for DrupalCon in India? Now, last year we had an announcement that the Drupal Association were not doing DrupalCon Europe. Okay? For 1 year. What we did in that 1 year was we found a way. And this has never been done before. And now the Linux Journal people are asking us how it's working. Was we got an external company, Kooni, who do conferences. That's all they do. Yeah, that's what they do for a job, for a company. So what they're doing is they are running DrupalCon Europe on our behalf. And what that means is, we don't have the Drupal project, and Drupal Association won't have a financial risk by holding DrupalCon Europe. DrupalCon Europe used to lose money. It used to lose $200,000 a year. Yeah? I mean, it's quite hard to stand up here and say that. And which is not good, because that's $200,000 a year we can't spend on Drupal.org servers. It's $200,000 a year we can't spend on me coming here, yeah? It's $200,000 we can't spend on community cultivation grants. So we're setting this up with Kooni for Drupal Europe. Now, if it works in Drupal Europe, and this is for Kooni to decide, What did I just say?
Well,
oh, Drupal Call Europe, yeah. If it works for them, yeah, then there is nothing stopping them doing DrupalCon Asia, or DrupalCon India, or whatever you want to call it, or Australasia, or South America, wherever. And because of the size of Kuwomi, and because of their global reach, was one of the reasons we chose them, actually, because we had three companies we were looking at. It will cost them less to do DrupalCon Asia than it would us. And it will be much easier for them. So I can't promise you anything. But what I can say is it's not out of the question, and it's much more likely than it would have been if we'd have kept with the old system. Yeah? So it's more likely, you're right that absolutely we should be looking at it, looking at the figures. Yeah? But we need to make sure it happens. It's not just our choice. Kuwomi have got to think, can we make money on this? And then they will be happy to do it. Yeah? Alright? And a lot of that will come down to DrupalCon Europe. If DrupalCon Europe is a success, and Kuwomi are like, hey, this is great, we're making money on this, fantastic, yeah? Then they're more likely to go, hey, let's do this worldwide. So, let's hope we can make that happen. So I'll be looking forward to when you buy your tickets to Europe, Andrew. any other questions?
We have one. Yeah, quick question again. So, what happens is, a lot of time, youngsters underestimate the value of the contribution, right? And how that can help with their own growth in terms of career, in terms of, as a person, and getting the exposure, right? Now, we as citizens, don't force people to contribute, right? That's not the culture that we have. We definitely try and encourage as much as we can as an organization. But, I think how Drupal Association can help in that, right? In doing, giving them more, ideas on how do you go in and why you should contribute and how it's going to help your career.
Okay, I can answer that actually. So if I go back up to that slide with my profile on it. Okay. This is my CV. This is my Drupal CV. CV, is that a word that's used here? I don't know.
Is that your picture?
It's my old picture, yeah. My hair changes colour a lot. Okay. my hair is blue today. It was blonde a few weeks ago. It was pink. It's been every colour, believe me. So this is my CV. One of the things that's the main thing on this page is if you scroll down, which I can't do now, this is a screenshot, it lists my contributions and there's a few of them. I'm top 200 Drupal core contributor. So it shows what I've been doing and shows that I am active in the community. It shows that you can't do contribution just on your own. It's not possible. You need to work with people. And if that's the case, it shows that I know people. It shows that I've got connections in the community because of all the different places I've worked and contributed. For employers, that's useful, okay? Employers look at this thing. They look here. They want, if you've got hundreds and hundreds of contributions, employers are thinking, I add this person to my company, I get their contributions appearing on my organization profile as well, which moves my organization profile up the marketplace too. Yeah. It also